Hello again, everyone. It's the Black Knight here, and I've come to a kind of unpleasant realization as I ponder the upcoming DLC for Grand Theft Auto Online, is that for the last couple of months, I have been a slave. A slave to the Biker DLC. Think about it. Prior to the Biker DLC, most of my gaming was put towards making money for the Biker DLC. You know, we knew there were some awesome things coming out, and the Biker DLC was awesome. I'm not trying to take away from any of the things going on with the Biker DLC. But I spent my time either getting ready for the Biker DLC and then trying to partake in the Biker DLC, try to get at least select vehicles from the Biker DLC, and a lot of good things going on here. I mean, right now you're watching a video of Deadline, and I love Deadline. Love playing Deadline. It's a great game. And I've got a Shotaro. That's my go-to bike now when I'm racing. I've got a Hakachu Drag, because for a little while there, that was the fastest bike in the world here as far as GTA Online was concerned. Now it's just a tick slower than the Shotaro. And in certain situations, it may still be faster. And I've got my Scooby-Doo van. I've got a couple other things. I've got my motorcycle club. Didn't invest in the businesses, but we'll get more into that later. And I've been doing biker missions and, you know, set up this biker thing, that biker thing, make more money for the get more biker bikes. And after a while, you think, you know, do I want to do that all over again with importing and exporting? Now, follow me on this. What I kind of figured out from bikers is bikers really was basically finance and felony on bikes. You had a lot of the missions are very similar, that you drive a good distance, and they've structured things a little bit differently. But the feel, the flavor of it, especially the missions where you have a business and you have to be tied to a public session. The reason I didn't get the biker business is because I've had so much fun with the CEO businesses, where you get so far and then somebody in a Hydra takes you out with a whole bunch of missiles. And that's basically the same thing that happened with bikers. If you have to deal with the people in public, it becomes very random. And I think the whole point was to encourage you to have a huge posse protecting you from all the bad guys. And this would set up spectacular gun battles. And I'm sure that happens. It's really, you know, you have your fighter protection. They've got their fighter protection. I'm mostly playing solo here. I'm mostly a lone wolf. A lone agent out here when I'm in the GTA universe. Every once in a while, I do have a couple buddies who I'll get to hang out with, but you know, our schedules are so varied, it's hard to pull off. So, now I'm looking at the importing and exporting businesses that are supposed to be coming out. I'm guessing they said it was an extension of the CEO offices. You need a CEO office, which I have, just to do it. And there's going to be a lot of things where I have a feeling it's going to be, okay, go to a certain place, steal a special car, bring it back to your warehouse, and then find a buyer for said car, take the car out, get it blown up by Hydra. I mean, I have a feeling that's how it's going to go. Even if they don't give them something for blowing it up, people will end up doing that just because they can. And it's just how it is. You'll get somebody with a Hydra and $20 million, and they don't care what's going on. They're just going out today to ruin your day. I could be wrong. They're supposed to be encouraging people to steal the car from you, and you know, basically shoot you through the windows and or grab you out of the car and take off with it somehow. And that could be trickier, and it's more rewarding. But I mean, there's definitely going to be a player versus player element to it, which is fine, but which I don't know that... Do I want to kill myself to try to get into the league of having enough money to pull that off? Because after the biker stuff, after $2.5 to $3 million really on the Shotaro, once you get everything upgraded on it, I have to have almost $2 million, or at least $1.5 million in the Hakachu Drag, probably $500,000 in the Scooby-Doo van. I've got another $500,000 in the Valentine's Day special, which I just built, which had nothing to do with bikers, but I spent the money on it. Then you've got the investment in the bike shop. I mean, I've gone through a lot of millions of dollars. I've ground a lot of double money rounds on adversary modes and in races when they had the races with the cunning stunts. I mean, really, even including cunning stunts. How I have done so many cunning stunts races that I have videos out to March, and I'm going to continue doing that because really, racing is one of the things I really like to do in this game. If I have the choice, that's what I'll be doing. Either that or Deadline. Those are my two big things. And I'm looking at it like, do I right now want to make 100% of my game time, 100% of my computer time, chasing that goal? Do I want to get myself a lot of money? Because this looks like it could be even more expensive than bikers. There's some really special stuff that's coming out, and I don't want to really go into any of the rumors, but some apparently really expensive and really special stuff that's coming out. Stuff that I know I'm going to want eventually. We're talking, they've got a car that's supposed to be like a Knight Rider kind of thing. That you've got the possibility for adding a 20 car to a 60 car garage to your CEO offices just to keep your stuff, and then another whole warehouse just to keep cars that you're going to sell. And there's supposed to be collections of cars you can sell. I mean, there's all kinds of things that are supposed to be going on. And I do applaud Rockstar. Rockstar, thank you for finally doing something with stealing cars. You ever think about that? Really? Deadline is one of my favorite games. What does this have to do with Grand Theft Auto? I'll give you a minute. Nothing! That's right, absolutely nothing. It has everything to do with Disney and Tron and all the things we love about Disney and Tron, but it's got absolutely nothing to do with Grand Theft Auto. This is going to be a truly, perhaps the most quintessential Grand Theft Auto update that there is, and I'm going to take it slowly. I'm not going to kill myself, and I don't advise that you kill yourself. Don't feel that panic that you have to get out there and get everything at once. Don't, you know, I mean, if you've got a lot of disposable income and you want to buy $500 in shark cards because that will give you, you know, the let's see, what would 500 shark cards get you? That'd be like about 40 million. 40 million might be the what you need here to get everything. I mean, that's a ballpark possibility here. They're talking about a lot of cars coming into this game. I think we start having to look at things. If you're like me and you cannot play 8 hours a day, and you're certainly, you know, going to spend your money in other places other than shark cards, because that's just how life works. Nothing against buying shark cards. That's what keeps these DLCs coming. You want to support the game. At some point, I have bought a shark card in the past. I'm sure I'll get another shark card in the future. And there's something that's really kind of, this is limited and I want to get this, and this is specific something that's important to me. Fine. Nothing wrong with that. But I think for most people, if you're especially you kids, you weren't supposed to be playing it anyway. When you're trying to get shark card money from your parents, you're like, no, you're not buying virtual cards. Go play the game and earn the money like I did when I was a kid. Just pace yourselves, you know? This is DLC. I don't think is going to be limited edition anything. There may be some sales that are limited. But, you know, the truth of the matter is, and this is true in life, is that something that is on sale that you don't have enough money to buy is much more expensive than something that is not on sale that you have enough money to buy. And if you're patient, you'll be able to get however many things that are out there and the things you really want to get. There are some things going on right now that I might participate in. They are putting Deadline back on double money for the next 4 days or so, or something like that. Hey, I'll play some Deadline, make some extra money. Sure. I've only got $150,000 in the game right now. I can't buy anything. I'm lucky I can pay my mechanics. There's really, you know, now I have a lot of money. It's been spent. You've probably watched me spend it. You can see in the videos where the money goes. And I don't want, in case I have anybody out there thinking, all right, when is the Black Knight going to get out there and get this and get that? Gang, I really I don't want to be a slave to the game the way I was before. Not that, you know, I don't want to make videos for you guys, but I want to make videos where I'm enthused, you know? And right now, coming off bikers, it's kind of like if you've just eaten like 6 slices of pizza. And someone comes up to you and says, hey, guess what we just bought? A pizza! Do you want some pizza? And, you know, even if the toppings are different, You might say, well, can I take some home? Because this is too much pizza. You know, if you've eaten an entire chocolate cake, and then someone offers you, you know, a vanilla cake, or, you know, perhaps, you know, let's go crazy. Let's say it's even better. Let's say it's a Dutch chocolate cake, or, you know, like a German chocolate cake, that kind of, something with cherries and all stuff on it. You're not going to be enthused. You're already full, and I'm kind of already full of buying new vehicles and upgrading new vehicles and making money for new vehicles and then getting vehicles and this and that and the other thing. Heck, I still don't even have my sixth garage. I mean, I'm carred out. I'm biked out, and I want to do this on a slow grind. I want to play the game when I'm in the mood to play the game. And I'm not giving up on the game, mind you. I have not run out of love for GTA Online. I still play it. I want to do some more races before they introduce a bunch of cars that are faster than mine. Currently in the fleet, I've got the fastest of every car that you can have as far as the stunt stuff is concerned. I've got an RE7B. I've got a custom Saber Turbo all tricked out at Benny's. I've got an LG. Everybody should have an LG. It's free. There's no excuse. Go get an LG. And I've got, let's see, that's the muscle. They've got the sports. The bikes. I've got both of the fastest bikes that could, you know, that you can argue back and forth. I've got the Kachu Drag. I have got the Shotaro. And the Shotaro is my go-to because it's just easier to drive really fast. It handles impeccably. The Hakachu handles well. It handles a little funny to me because I always feel like the tail's coming around a little too quick. It's like they used the model for the regular Hakachu and then put a tail on it. So it throws me off a little bit. And sometimes when you're landing, it just bounces like crazy. I don't know if it's that big rear wheel, but stuff happens to it. So I prefer, the Shotaro. If you're good with the Hakachu, you will beat a Shotaro. It can be done. These bikes have different strengths, and depending on the track, on any given day, you know, things can happen. So now, right now, I have as much advantage as I'm going to have until they come out with the next fastest thing. And I don't know what the next fastest thing is going to be. Are they going to come out with new supercars? You know, the one I wouldn't mind too much is if they come out with a faster version of the LG, because the LG is, of course, my favorite supercar still. I still like the feel of that one the best. And, you know, of course, the Koenigsegg, which is the basis for the LG, has the LG. I'm saying LG, and I really mean Entity. Koenigsegg which is the basis for the Entity, my Entity XF, LG, Entity, fastest. It's all that kind of wrapped up in there. But Koenigsegg has the Koenigsegg 1, which I believe might be the fastest car going right now. It's a small little powerful thing that is simply crazy. I don't know if it's the absolute fastest thing in the world, but it might be faster than the cars that they have featured as of late. You know, the McLaren P1, the LaFerrari, in sheer top speed realm of things. I don't know what would happen if you tried to put them on the track. Hey, Grand Tour guys, get out there. Get yourself a Koenigsegg 1 and see what happens. But please try to live through it. We need you guys around. So, I mean, there's things that can go on. There's things that can happen where they'll introduce cars which are faster and more expensive. I mean, if they have a supercar that costs more than $2.5 million, $3 million, $4 million, it better be the fastest thing in the game. Otherwise, you're going to be really disappointed. I mean, that's a lot of money for looks. You know, so there's, you know, I might try to get a whole bunch of racing in the meantime because I'm in the mood to do it. But, you know, there's other things I want to do too. I want to start getting into Star Citizen. I want to start getting back into Freelancer. There's, you know, Kerbal Space Program at some point, just to be different, you know. And, you know, I'm starting to feel like playing TF2 again. So, I mean, there's a lot of things going on that I'd like to do. And I'm looking at, like, all right, do I abandon everything else to try to crank money for this DLC? And you got to realize, I mean, there were days when I had races going solo where I was just cranking through them. And I would just go one after another for hours. And it's, you know, you make the money eventually. But, I mean, it's just, it becomes work. And I don't want this to be work because it'll come off as work at some point. And then that's going to ruin the videos, you know? If I'm not having fun, you're probably not having fun. So that's what we want to avoid. And I think you guys should avoid that too. If you're not having fun with the game, don't crank on it just to get a whole bunch of money so you can get a car. You'll get it eventually. You know, I'm sure at this point, unless you're brand new to the game, in which case you're not getting any of this, take your time. You know, get yourself, steal a muscle car, drive around, have fun with it, do some missions, you know, do the heists, do whatever you want to do there. Be patient. You need to be some patient things going on here. Because what they are doing with all this is they know that you're just broke from the bikers. That's why they're introducing it right now, so you'll go get shark cards. And again, no problem with getting shark cards, but, you know, don't break the bank to do it. I mean, if you want to do that and you've got the disposable income, I mean, there was a guy who gave a Star Citizen $15,000 in pledges, and he's got every ship they've got. I think he got to meet Chris Roberts. I think he had lunch with him. I mean, there's guys who do this, and if that's your thing, hey, you're not spending the money at the bars or whatever, it's perfectly reasonable. I have no problem with that. But don't feel pressure like you have to. Do it because you want to. There should be nothing here where you feel like, I have to do this. Oh, if I don't have to do this. Anybody else feel that? Because I was feeling that with the bikers. Especially because I have this channel. I felt like I had to be ahead of the curve on stuff. You know, I'm not saying I'm Mr. Boss for the win there. But I felt like I had to be ahead of things. And it's not a good feeling. I think we have to stick with the good feelings here. We have to try and keep things under control. You know, do what you want to do. But don't do what you think that you have to do because they're making you feel like you have to do it. The timing on this is classic marketing. And it's particularly touching right now because they're doing it all to you at Christmas. I mean, Amazon's doing the same thing. Look at these deals! You have to buy it all now! Come on, or this deal will never be there until, I don't know, next week. Everybody's doing the same thing, you know? You're getting the same thing from Best Buy, Toys R Us, I don't know, Kohl's. I don't know, just pick anybody. I actually don't know what Kohl's the sales are. But they're all doing the same thing. Hey, this is the time you have to get it. You know, Christmas is coming. Do you have everything on your Christmas list? And, you know, folks, you know, if the people that you're buying stuff for care that much about what their stuff is, then, you know, you all have to have a talk and have a hug and do different things. Take the pressure off yourself, you know. Just live your life. Do what you need to do. Do what you have to do. But do what you want to do, too. Don't go crazy over stuff. We're all getting jerked around in the consumerism of the whole thing. And this is really interesting because it's stuff that doesn't actually exist. Like, we're buying cars that if they shut down the GTA Online servers, it's not like they send you a little model of them that you can keep on your desk. They're gone. And, you know, someday that will eventually happen. This isn't a long-term investment necessarily. It might be. Maybe it'll be 10 years. Who knows? Maybe something else will be out. You won't care that the hours upon days upon weeks that you've put into this game to get the latest and greatest of everything is now gone. I had to go through that once. I had to go through a server shutdown, and that was painful, you know. I spent 4 or 5 years on the Get On It server, and I had a lot of ships. Oh, yeah, a lot of ships. And a lot of money, a lot of ships. I was the leader of the base clan. That's where it all started. So naturally, I've got all of these ships and these, you know, these freighters and this and that. And they said, well, we're not doing it anymore. Have a nice day. It was Get On It. Then it was the Aussie Freelancers. Then it was goodbye. So then we started up on the Freelancer Universe server, a.k.a. Flu. Shout out to RoboCop, the guy who runs that server. Now, there's a guy I should send money to before I get a shark card, because he's been doing this for so many years. With that server set up, I don't know if it's in his basement, in his living room, if it's in some mythical place, in a tree, in a magic forest. I don't know where he does it. I really don't. But awesome guy, really amazing person. And you get stuff in that game, too. You send them, if you do a donation, you get all kinds of special weapons and shields and stuff like that for your ships. And I don't intend to stop playing Freelancer anytime soon. So that's, I owe him that. Anytime I've wanted to do it, there's always been some other kind of financial thing going on. So we'll see as we get through Christmas. Once the ham's on the table, maybe we'll see what we can do there. But he has awesomeness. Check that out, you know. The whole Freelancer Universe deal, if you're into that kind of thing. But that's kind of, you know, now I'm just tracking completely off topic here. which I am wont to do. You guys know that. I tend to ramble a bit. But, yeah. So, make sure that if you're excited for this, and you should be, because there's going to be a lot of really cool stuff coming out, that's great. But don't lose sleep over it. I mean, don't go crazy and think, oh, I'm broke now. What am I going to do? How am I going to make all this kind of money? How, what am I supposed to do? Like, this is a game. I've done this so many times. When I played Freelancer back in the day, I took it entirely too seriously. There are people out there right now who hate me because of stuff that has gone on in the game. And, you know, just the fact that I had to be an administrator on this, on the forums there, and that, you know, part of your job was kind of breaking up fights on the forums. If you took somebody's side, well, you're just dead to them. Everybody took it too seriously. We really did. We didn't have as much fun as we should have. We had a lot of fun. But, I mean, there was a lot of times where there were bitter feelings back and forth. And, you know, I'm over them all now. But, I mean, things went on. And you can't take... Don't take your gaming too seriously. It is not life. It is not real. And don't be a slave to the game. Like, I've been a slave to bikers for the last couple of months here. However long this has been going on or in preparation. Really, even through cunning stunts. I've been a slave to cunning stunts, too. I've been doing a lot of this, and I'm at the point where, although I'm very happy for what's coming out, and I'm looking forward to it, I don't want to kill myself to go get it just yet. So, eventually, you're going to see me racing. You're going to see me playing Deadline. They got a Deadline double going on. I like playing Deadline. I'll do that. That's not me being a slave to the game. That's me being just basically generally addicted to video games. Which is somehow different, but I don't know how. On that note, this is the Black Knight, and I'm trying to think, do I want to do a whole commentary on the rest of this particular level? I mean, things went very well for me for, I think, well, at least one round. but there's some very good guys playing here, and you can, if you watch it, it's very good. There's some magical stuff going on in this round of Deadline. I think it would be hypocritical for me to force myself to re-watch all of this gameplay if I'm saying I'm not being a slave to the biker updates. So, I'm going to leave it here for you, for your amusement, for your consumption, because it was cool. I don't want to throw it away. I mean, it is cool stuff going on here. We're going to make this the bonus footage, and on that note, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Black Knight. Have a great night.
How you doing? Listen, I'm working on something. Something interesting, I think, but I need a little time. Anyway, I got a request.